Gentlemen, I'm Natasa Todorovic from the Red Cross of Serbia, and I'm IMPEA representative. Today I will speak about prevention and respond to the violence, the abuse and neglect. One of the lessons we have learned through the past year of the pandemic is that large-scale emergencies such as these are, of course, huge global problem, but they are also a perfect storm of risk factor for elder abuse. One way of looking at it is to break it down to three main components. The first component is easy to understand. For older persons, social isolation is a known risk factor for experiencing elder abuse. Limited access to healthcare services they have received up to this point, and to non-COVID healthcare, such as regular checkups, diagnostic, may lead to worsening health and decrease their autonomy, which may expose them to a higher risk of abuse. This also may increase the risk of disability for person with chronic condition, which will again increase their dependency and therefore put them at risk of abuse and violence. There is also worry about financial issue with older person having to spend more out-of-pocket funds to cover healthcare services because the system is not capable of meeting their needs during the epidemic. On top of that, they maybe have to use their pensions to financially support family members who lost their income again due to the pandemic. And while in Serbia, pensions were paid regularly to all pensioners during the lockdown, this had additional consequences in exposing them to increased risk of financial abuse. All this may lead to increased depression and anxiety, making them more vulnerable to abuse. The other component is to do with the informal and formal caregivers who are hit especially hard by the pandemic and the response measures. We know that informal caregivers are the backbone of any long-term care service system in the world. And during the pandemic, they are faced with all the problems everyone else faces, such as risk of infection, movement restriction, loss of income security. But on top of it, they have all additional problems related to the providing care to older person. On the other hand, informal caregivers, they didn't recognize by governments during the pandemic. The Red Cross of Serbia of research on mental health of informal caregivers during the pandemic shows more than half of them had insufficient funds, one-third lacks necessary information, more than one-fifth needed respite services, more than two-thirds are scared for their health or health of older person. Almost one-third showed symptoms of depression. When put together, all these factors increase the risk of elder abuse. Additionally, the older population, but also staff of residential care centers, was under the significant pressure due to epidemiological measures preventing visits and residents leaving the premises, and require staff to stay in their workplace for 2 weeks shift, increasing the risk of mental health issue and elder abuse. The third component is widespread ageism, one of the root causes of elder abuse, with its prejudice and stereotypes about older person. The mirror image of these treating older population as homogeneous and denied its diversity, which prevents us from identifying those parts of the population who are under the higher risk of abuse, such as functional dependent person, older women, social excluded older person. During the pandemic, older person across the world have been treated either with overall protective paternalistic attitude or have been targets of unjust rage. Both sides of that coin are bad. Taking agency from older person in the name of the protection is just concealed force, and then blaming older person for decline economy during the pandemic is not just against but also completely wrong. A constant issue related to the emergency anywhere in the world is data collection and reporting usually fail to capture unique way different group in the population of older person are affected. Usually, we only get scheduled studies on older person, and even then data is not disaggregated appropriately by age and gender, so we get bulk figures and little useful data. We then create prevention and intervention programs without understanding and analyzing specific risk and protective factors, believing that one size fits all approach will be sufficient. But it is not, and it creates discrimination. In Serbia, for example, the pandemic measures, including very strict prohibition of movement for person over 65, putting all of them in detention at their homes for weeks on end. Isolation and separation from their loved ones, and the fear of illness, fear of being unable to meet their needs related to essential supplies, created psychological stress. Red Cross of Serbia research results show risk of elder abuse increased during the lockdown, particularly for older person with decreasing functional ability and it need of additional support. The most prominent forms of abuse during this period were financial abuse and neglect, followed by psychological and physical abuse. Older person not using internet were isolated even further, which remind us to issue of digital divide. On the other hand, the Red Cross of Serbia had a successful remote services where older volunteers provided telephone support to their peers. Strict lockdown, imposing movement and contact restriction on older person must come with additional support, especially to person who have survived abuse and neglect or are at risk of abuse and neglect. It is also important to understand the epidemic response is also a learning process. This is not just optimize the resources in large-scale emergency, but it's also to minimize potential adverse effect of isolation, quarantine, and restriction that may disproportionately impact older population. But we must always remember there are two components to what is perceived a disaster: the hazard and vulnerability of certain population group. Both influence the effects of emergency event on this group. Therefore, reducing vulnerability of older person is contribute to reduce the effect of disaster, which is achieved through improving public policy to make older person access to human rights better. If we focus on this, we will not only lessen the risk of elder abuse during the large-scale disaster, but in fact create a more inclusive society. To that end, we should make sure we collect and study the data carefully so we can provide additional services and support to these who cannot access services that supported their autonomy. We should support informal caregivers because they are ones providing majority of services that support autonomy of older persons. That alone will not stop elder abuse, but it should lessen the risk. Then we should have telephone service that are easily accessible for older person exposed to violence with clear, simple procedure to report it. We should also make sure that all relevant information is available to us as many older person as possible, which means using multiple channels and not only relying on the internet in order to not leave them behind. Finally, we must ensure support to the civil sector that can contribute significantly to provide support and decreasing the risk of elder abuse. The COVID-19 pandemic should act as a wake-up call to include older person in emergency response planning, budgeting, staff allocation, and response activities, using their capacity and resources and voicing their concern and recommendation. This should be normal. We shouldn't have to even discuss it, but this is still somehow an ideal rather than reality. But we have not wakened yet. 1 year into the pandemic, data collection is still blind to diversity of older population. Measures and policies are still designed without meaningful participation of older person. Groups at higher risk still go unsupported. We still want to protect older person without giving them a seat at the table. We talk about preserving economy while completely neglect the large contribution older person make to economy worldwide. It is important to never forget that human rights do not expire as one ages, and that older person's human rights must be protected to the full extent of the applicable laws, just as anyone else's. A new UN Convention of Human Rights of Older Persons would be helping protect human rights of older persons at all levels in all stages. Thank you very much.